Welcome back. Imagine being in a new country trying to start a new life, but you don't speak the language. Or how about being from here and trying to get a job without an education?
Well, luckily for those who do face those barriers, there's the Minnesota Literary Council. Rena Sargentopoulos explains how the group is impacting many lives.
In the basement of a library on Minneapolis's north side. Is a place where success stories start.
Every day is a new challenge, and it's very inspirational being here.
Lloyd Brown is the coordinator of this open door learning center, one of six centers run by the Minnesota Literary Council. All places where people can find a path to their best future.
Our students come here to learn to speak and read and write English, or to take a GED class, or to study for a citizenship exam, and then they're better able to live with dignity and achieve their highest potential.
Sand. Which one is sand?
For many, English is the barrier, but for others, life has been their barrier.
I was a young parent, and I had to see about my own child, so it helped me. I had to get a job.
Mary Armstrong wasn't able to finish high school because she had to be a parent. Now she's so close to getting her GED and getting into cosmetology school.
When I first came here, I was like afraid of math. Like it was like not, I was running from math. But due to my teacher help, she really helped me get comfortable with, you know, learning some things.
So we've got the sum.
The Northside location alone is fueled by more than 100 volunteers, people from all different backgrounds.
As a healthcare lawyer.
Who, like Judy Walker, donate their time because they've seen the success stories firsthand.
Absolutely. Seen people who have hated math their entire life pass a math test that finally allows them to get their GED. People who came knowing nothing, working their way through an English as a second language program, and then going on to complete their GED program. Yeah, it's very humbling and energizing, and it just like, it's like the best part of the week coming here.
I don't see any mistakes.
The programs are free for the students, which eliminates the financial barrier, but it's so much more than that.
This is correct.
Very good.
It's support on a personal level from people who care deeply about other people, knowing that a helping hand is just that. A hand up, not a handout.
Without you, I wouldn't have been able to figure this out at home.
You can imagine the stories that people come here with, the adversity that they've faced in their lives, and they want to pick themselves up. They want to get an education. They know that that education is the key to improving their lives and getting out of this state of despair that maybe they're living in.
Yes, awesome.
Now, the Minnesota Literary Council needs volunteers, and you don't need teaching experience to help. They also have a fundraiser next Thursday, April 19th, featuring Grammy Award winner Angelique Kidjo. You can find all that information on our website, care11.com. Awesome.
Talk about an opportunity to make such a difference. Just an incredible program.
Yeah, wonderful job, and I hope they find more volunteers because obviously it's needed, and like you said, awesome volunteering experience.
Life-changing. We'll be right back.